Good day. We know that a hydrate is a compound that has salt containing certain amount of water in it. So in this case, our hydrate is given to have a formula. So let's just write it first here. It is a salt with water embedded in it. So in this case, our hydrate is given with a formula of CuCl2 or copper 2 chloride, with X here being the amount of water that is embedded in it, okay, per formula unit of the compound. So we are given that the mass of the hydrate is equal to 3.41. So this is the mass of this copper 2 chloride hydrate, and it's given here that after heating, the mass of the anhydrous, or this is the mass of the hydrate after water molecule is driven off, and it's given to be 2.69. So note that when a hydrate is heated, its water molecules gets evaporated. And so what is left is only the ionic compound or the salt. So in this case, this 2.69 grams also is equal to grams of CuCl2. So it follows that we can solve for the mass of water in the hydrate, which is just going to be equal to the mass of the hydrate less the mass of the salt. And this gives us 0.72. We can convert this into moles of water. So it's going to be our step 2. Convert this to moles of water by dividing the mass by the molar mass of water, which is equal to 18. And that gives us 0.72 over 18, where that's going to be equal to 0.04. We can also, let us also solve for the moles of the salt, CuCl2, which is grams of CuCl2 over its own molar mass. So we have 2.69, right, over 134 as its own molar mass. So we will get 0.02. And let us take down the ratio of the moles of water and the moles of CuCl2. Please ignore this. So we have moles of H2O again divided by the moles of CuCl2 over 0.02. And this gives us 2 over 1. So what does this ratio mean? This means that in the hydrate, for every 1 mole of copper 2 chloride, we have 2 moles of water. Therefore, the formula for the hydrate will be CuCl2 to H2O. So that means the X value that we have presented above is going to be equal to 2. So I hope that this is clear.